All right, so here we are, still live at SHOT Show 2019. You know, here's the thing. We can look at air guns all day long, but if you don't have the right pellet, the greatest air gun in the world will fail you miserably. And I think we've known that all from experience. Yep. So I'm here at Predator International with Mr. Dick Dickson, the man, the myth, the legend. And we're going to talk some new pellets, some new ammo coming out in the air gun world. Dick, how you doing, man?
We're doing good.
Yeah?
Business is good. The industry is strong, healthy.
Yeah.
And we hope that it continues. And with people like you around promoting our industry, it's bound to be terrific.
We're doing our best. See, I mean, you can say hello to a lot of air gunners right now, little airheads out there watching.
I'll tell you what, we appreciate every one of them. We think that our customers are the best in the world, and they appreciate quality.
Yeah.
And expect results. So that's what we try to deliver.
Well, so. And I think you've successfully done that for years now. So.
Well, it's a learning process, but we're always trying to better ourselves, better the product. JSB in the Czech Republic is always on cutting edge, even though it's a traditional initial cottage industry, it's grown and grown and grown, and JSB has done its best to keep up with the demand.
Right.
As air guns have increased in technology, for a long time, ammunition stayed the same.
Right.
So what JSB and Predator has tried to do is stay up with that technology and actually get ahead of the technology curve so that someday, when the guns come out, we've got the ammunition ready.
So it looks like you guys are ready. I know this is a paperweight, and this is funny, but I don't think we're too far away from this being a possibility in the air gun
world. We look at this, and this is a 45.
The 45 pellets.
Yeah. Now they're glued in.
They're glued in. Okay.
They're glued in. So.
I mean, that is, and we've shot these and we've used these and they work, but the fact that we have a skirted 45 caliber pellet is
absolutely
kind of mind blowing.
I mean, five
years ago, you'd have been like, well, we would never do that. That's crazy.
Well, like you say, next step.
It's unbelievable.
Yep.
So what are we looking at? What's new? What can we expect this year?
This year, you know, we're improving the quality control, actually trying to establish an electronic a viewing of each pellet. Currently, every pellet that JSB and Predator manufactures is literally hand-viewed under a microscope by a person, by a human eye. So
every single pellet
without exception.
And really?
And the rejection rate is 2%. So JSB has a building with 30, 35, 40 women under magnification and long tweezers. And they pick them up, they look at them, and they put them in the tin. But every pellet is viewed by a human being.
Wow, God bless those ladies, because
it's a tough job.
I would go, my head would explode.
And it takes months to train these women
to
look for the imperfections. So parting lines, damage of any kind, skirts that are bent, whatever, then are rejected and then remelded and made back in. Problem with air gun pellets, whether it's ours or anybody else, is that they're so heavy that damage occurs in shipping.
Okay.
So even though a lady reviews every one of these pellets, once it's put in a box, it ships from the Czech Republic to Germany, on a ship from Germany to Houston on a rail car to Denver, where our warehouse is located.
Yeah.
And then when UPS, USPS, and FedEx get a hold of these things, and they throw these things around like they're footballs, damage will occur.
Sure.
But it's our intent to make sure that every pellet that's received by our customers is in perfect shape.
Okay. All right.
So.
That's amazing. I mean, to hear that from you, I mean, I think that's something that no one would expect, that every single pellet is hand viewed.
Until I actually saw it myself, I couldn't believe it either.
Really?
But it is a fact. So.
Well, that explains the quality.
Yeah. So you ask about what's new. We've got, this is a new item for us here. You know, the 20 caliber has been kind of a stepchild within the air gun industry.
Right.
And 20 caliber is actually coming back. And
20 caliber?
20 caliber. And it's kind of a handy caliber for plinking, for taking out critters and varmints.
Yeah.
But again, like we were talking about the technology, some of these air guns have gotten so powerful that the traditional 20 caliber was too light.
Okay.
So we've designed another 20 that's heavier. It is called the heavy 20 caliber heavy.
So, okay. So it's a 15 grain.
It's almost
20 caliber.
It's almost a 16 grain, 15.89 grain.
Yeah. Okay.
So,
wow.
So then, in addition, we've come out with what's called the Hades.
The Hades.
The Hades, developed by Satan himself.
Well, phew, excuse God, me. We're live here. Yeah. We would cut that out of the show, but I had to sneeze. I don't know what to tell you.
You're for real. Look
live
at this.
Live TV. I mean? All right.
Okay.
I'm allergic to lead. It's not true at all. Not true at all.
This pellet is a hollow head design.
Oh, wow.
And it fractures. It's frangible.
Oh, look at this.
It literally pulls apart on impact. So it has great, almost instantaneous takedown abilities.
Okay.
So, fabulous.
Now, what's the advantage with something like this versus just a regular hollow point?
The fact that it does break apart.
Okay, whole thing, like it splits into pieces.
Exactly. So if you shoot a squirrel and you don't want it to run over to the widow lady's front porch,
sure,
this will take it down.
Okay.
Okay.
The Hades. Love that.
Now it's right now it's going to be available in the 22 caliber. We've got the 25s coming out probably around the first of the summer.
Okay.
So coming up.
So is this a new design that we're going to see? I mean, is that going to grow into the 357s and 45s?
We don't know yet.
Okay.
We don't know yet. We want to see how the market takes to it before we actually invest in the production of higher caliber, bigger caliber products.
So, right.
So.
Because in the big bores, I mean, these polymags are.
They're devastating.
Yeah, I mean, we shot a, you guys probably remember, I shot that 350-pound pig with my dad, ear holding with one of those, and
it's all over.
Yeah,
lights
done out. Deal.
Yeah.
It's a big old pig, too. Really big pig.
We're also promoting more of our lead-free, as everybody knows.
Sure.
You know, lead is a political football.
Yeah.
And, you know, we...
It's a great way to put it.
Yeah, and we can't deny it.
Yeah.
So rather than avoid it and not look at it, we've come out with what's called the GTO pellet.
Okay.
And the GTO pellet is a tin-based pellet that is slightly lighter weight than lead, but performs equal to, and in some cases, better.
Really?
Than lead. So we've got a lot of the junior ROTC groups that are using wad cutter 177s.
Yeah.
Are using our GTO pellets on an exclusive basis. And winning championships and meets and so forth.
Okay.
Against traditional lead pellets.
So, yeah.
So it's...
I mean, is there any real disadvantage to... Is it just the weight? Is that the main thing? Is just the you might not get that as heavy a pellet as you want?
It's not as heavy, but surprisingly, you don't have to do much adjustment on the lead-free versus the lead.
Yeah.
It shoots almost equal without any kind of initial adjustment.
So sure.
You shoot a few rounds and you'll know how your gun's going to react to it.
So okay.
No damage to the barrel. It's slightly harder than lead, but performs, like I say, equal to. So
okay.
We're really proud of the GTO. It was something that surprised us. You know, we wanted to come up with something that the kids, especially in junior ROTC, could compete with, and nothing on the market was out there for them.
Right.
So, and a lot of schools are eliminating lead, and so we decided to come up with the GTO.
There you go. I want to talk about the monsters. These are super heavy, redesigned 22s and such. And I saw them a lot at the Extreme Bench Rest. And,
sure.
And I believe all the guns that placed in the top five were shooting this
the
pellet.
Monsters, yeah.
What's the idea behind this?
Well, initially there was the traditional monsters, both in 177 and 22s.
Yeah.
And it didn't perform as well in all guns across the board.
Okay.
So JSB said, let's come up with another slightly different design in the skirt itself, and that's what they did. So now we offer both. We have the redesign in 177 and 22s and the traditional 177 monsters in and 22s in the monsters. So you know, it's like a personality. Every gun has its own personality.
Sure.
And so now we offer two. And surprisingly, some guys say that, you know, they've never had better performance on the redesigns.
Right.
Others say it doesn't work, and that's why two were designed for two specific types of barrels and performance.
I think it's safe to say the one thing you guys definitely do is you offer options. Everyone should be able to find anything and everything they want.
We listen. We try to listen.
JSB.
And what's nice is that our consumers, our customers out there that shoot, let us know what we're doing wrong,
right,
and make really concrete suggestions on what we can do right.
Okay. So, all right.
All right.
Dick?
Hey, always,
man,
always a pleasure.
Always, our pleasure, man. We as air gunners appreciate the effort and the quality you guys put into your pellets. I mean, it makes our guns, it makes us, let's be honest, it makes us a lot better shooters. Every time I don't hit the same hole, you know, I blame the pellet. It's always my fault.
It's
we know
never
that.
Your fault.
It is my fault.
Don't admit it.
It's never the pellet.
Well,
so,
we want to take this opportunity and thank our customers. So Predator and JSB truly are humbled by the way that the industry has taken to our product, and thank you very much.
Okay, there you go, guys. That's it from Predator International. We are going to be live in the next 15 minutes with Air Venturi, so stick with us. Dick, appreciate it, man.